We are really enjoying life in Hawaii. We're enjoying life in the Army. It's not perfect. Why did you cut your hair?
Don't ask mommy video.
Most of my travels around the world was because my dad was in the Navy.
Yes.
And because I went to a military school.
Yes.
Overseas.
So
I think that's partially.
I don't really consider Hawaii part of the United States. I know that's really bad. Some people are. If you've lived in Hawaii, you may understand what I mean by that. But this is my first time that I've lived outside the United States, is what I'm trying to say.
Continental.
Right. But to me, it's outside. Right. This is not like America. This is very different. And so I'm really loving it. But for John, those of you who don't know John is spoiled. Okay, let me tell you about John here. John spent like the first 6 to 7 years of his life in Japan.
8, 9.
Yeah. And then he got to spend 2 years in London when he was in high school playing soccer and traveled all of Europe. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. It has been an amazing year. We wanted to slow down and thank you guys. You guys have been so engaged. I love reading your comments. We've had people reach out to us from across the world asking questions, and that really helps keep, especially me, keeps me motivated to continue to put out these videos, and I'm really grateful. This year has been amazing, and I've been reflecting on how blessed we've been, like coming to Hawaii, being stationed here.
I mean, looking at it like career-wise, it's probably the best duty station I could have gotten.
Yeah.
Like, as much as I wanted a deploying unit, and you know, deploy, it was better to probably get a place like this that we don't deploy. Yeah, we train a decent amount, but it allowed me to kind of slowly get back into
military life
to learn Army, and gives me the chance to try to knock out as many schools as possible before we get to another duty station.
John's been really blessed in that, and the girls and I have been really blessed in being able to be here in the really beautiful place, just adventure. I know a lot of people don't like being stationed in Hawaii, but we are probably we really like it. I think John probably would hate it if it wasn't for surfing, but for right now, snorkeling and paddleboarding, those are, like, I love swimming in the ocean.
Here.
Which is amazing. Yeah, here.
I like swimming in the ocean here. It's like bath water.
Swimming in the ocean in California? No. No?
Maine?
No. Maine? No. North Carolina? No.
North Carolina wasn't too bad.
But there's
after a storm, it was warm.
Yeah, but after,
after a storm,
you have, like, a lot of...
You got a lot of sharks.
Not just, like, any sharks. You have, I think,
all
bull sharks.
Yeah.
And that's, like, no, we're not.
Yeah, there's,
we're not
there's a lot.
So, speaking of that, of course, John's now home for the holidays, and we had to go paddleboarding, and we had to go snorkeling. And we try to combine those two things by taking the paddle boards out into Electric Beach. It was a perfect day, right? Like, the ocean was so calm and flat. But we took the paddle boards out. And it was a little bit of a learning experience trying to combine.
It was a little windy too.
Yeah, it was.
So it made it harder.
It was really rough because John was staying on the paddleboard with Haley, because Haley's like, I'm not getting in the water, you're crazy. Like, all those snorkeling lessons, No, not getting in the water. And I don't blame her. It was deep, and it was deep blue. Got in, and John and Haley immediately started drifting, and so Alex and I had to do this quick, like, oh crud, like, swim to catch them. Oh, we gotta book it, swim, and of course we finally catch them. Alex gets on there like a beached whale. Like, oh my god, and here comes this
charter
boat with all these tourists that have paid to come snorkel in Electric Beach, and they're all like looking at us with their cameras as Alex is like, like, wave to them as they go by. So Alex was actually freaking me out a little bit. So she was having fun, but she would do these like panicked freak swim motions. And I am actually terrified of sharks. I've never...
Doesn't help that you've been watching a lot of shark attack.
Shark videos. Yeah. Ever since that one like shark video that we did, I've like, it's all popping up on my YouTube feed. I'm like, oh my god, there's another one, like, so it probably doesn't help me at all. But then Alex, we get into the deep blue. The water is just perfectly blue. And she starts doing these like panic swim motions, like just
calm movement. Smooth.
Calm, child, calm. You're freaking me out here. Don't attract any sharks, that is not good. So it didn't quite work out for snorkeling and paddleboarding. We're gonna have to figure out a way, maybe just bring 550 cord and tie ourselves to the paddleboard so that it's easy to pull ourselves. But at the same time, I don't wanna get stuck in the line. Like, that kind of freaks me out. If you guys have any suggestions, let us know. We're gonna make this work.
Oh, you know what we could do?
What?
We could take a long surf leash.
And tie it?
Surfboard leash and tie it onto that, tie it onto our foot.
Yeah, so at least, because that was the hardest part, because even though John was on the paddleboard, we had two paddleboards, so he was holding on to both paddleboards. And because he was holding on to the boards and had Haley, he couldn't paddle to keep up with us. Like, the wind kept taking him. And yeah, maybe we'll do the leash. We'll try the leash. Because it was gorgeous. There were, obviously, I couldn't quite see them, but you could tell that there were scuba divers all around us because of all the bubbles. And it was really, the fish were really deep down there. And that's one of the things that I want to get better at is diving down and learning to like pressurize. Because I went down a little bit and just the pressure was like, oh, ooh.
Yeah.
So I have to work on that. I also need to get diving fins, the cute little snorkel fins that I have. Just. When we were paddleboarding back in, right? And we've got this headwind that we're facing.
It sucked.
It was a long paddle in. So, like, I was digging into it. We're doing great. Alex and I are beating John and Haley. And I feel pretty good. And then we finally got close enough to shore where the wind kind of subsided a little bit. So I just kind of took a break. And I was like, yeah, this is not nice. And I turn around and John's now in front of me. And if you don't know anything about our family, know this. We are highly competitive. Our children are very competitive with each other. And John and I are very competitive with each other. Even though I lose most of the time, unfortunately. I still can't stand the idea of losing, and so I have to put maximum effort into it. And yeah.
Cheating! 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 Ah!
Haley and I saw you guys ahead, and we're like, I think they're racing us. I think they're trying to beat us. And so we just started paddling.
All right, jump, Alex.
I was working so hard. And if it wasn't for, I just should never have taken my guard off. I was just like, oh, yeah.
Well, then you were like fighting everything, going at an angle. We came like this way to ride the waves in.
Oh, I
hate you. So we were riding waves in to help us catch up.
Yeah, and then you just cut in front of me and like completely stopped me. Just, it was so nice to just relax on the beach. It really was a very beautiful day. So, as blessed as we are, it's not without its obstacles. So, the other day, Haley, like, I've been actually really sick. November has been a really tough month. I don't know about everyone else, but it seems like we've just been getting head colds after head colds, especially Alex and I. If you're wondering why I haven't been putting out as many videos, that is the reason why. No one wants to see, like, the disaster that was this past month.
I don't know how I didn't get sick.
That's because you were gone.
Yeah, but we're in the cold, hot, cold, hot.
I don't know, but for Alex, this is her first year going to physical school, and we're first year in Hawaii. We've just moved. I don't know what it is. 2 years of everything combined into one fall season, and maybe you guys are in the same position, but I feel like we were just getting sick and sick and sick.
Mom was really sick. She was passing the whole day.
Because I was like,
I thought Mom was going to die.
Barely surviving. John's gone on the Big Island. I come around, and all of a sudden, Haley has a lot less hair. Okay, Haley. Did you cut your hair?
Yeah. But not all of it.
I come home, I see everybody, I see Haley's hair. Wasn't gonna say anything, because Anna cuts her hair. I wasn't gonna say anything. Like, that shit looks bad. And then, I think it was the next day, though. I think it was the next day, because you get home, you don't wanna organize your gear, deal with your gear. So no, like, I think it was the next day or maybe 2 days later, I was like putting the gear away and looking through for like laundry and stuff like that. And I look in the corner and I'm like, what is this? And I thought it was just like the dog hair that just kept getting missed and it just all compiled into this one little corner. And I pick it up. I'm like, no, that's not dog hair. And I look at Haley, I'm like, this is like Haley's hair. And I'm like, is this Haley's hair? And she's like, yeah, she cut her own hair. I'm like, oh, okay, well, that makes sense then, because it looks so bad.
So bad.
All right, we are incredibly muddy. So we are going to push the boundaries on what is socially acceptable, even for Hawaii standards. And we're about to walk into a mall.
Another thing that happened that I feel like I didn't really talk about is Alex actually got her ears pierced. Mm. And this was a reward for good behavior in school. She had been a chatterbox the first month or so of school. And so one of the things to help her correct this behavior was some kind of reward for good behavior. She picked getting her ears pierced. That's what she wanted. So we made a deal that she had to be quiet in class for so long, ideally long enough that we established a good habit, right? Like, so that we wouldn't just stop when we got the ears pierced, which worked. It totally worked. Haven't had any complaints from the teacher. She's been rocking it. Awesome. But the part that didn't go quite so well is we actually went to go get her ears pierced, and to me, it didn't hurt that much. And so when she was asking how much it hurts, I was like, it's just going to pinch. It's not going to be that bad. This is my child who throws herself on surfboards and dirt bikes and mountain bikes and doesn't really cry very much on that, right? Okay? We went to go get the ears pierced. And let's just let the video play itself.
Just going to look straight ahead, okay? Two, three.
We are really enjoying life in Hawaii. We're enjoying life in the Army. It's not perfect. It is, you know, it's, what do you call it? It's, you know, it's definitely bureaucracy at times. It can feel like you get lost in the not so common sense things.
Yeah, there's a lot of that.
But we would never have been able to live in Hawaii without the Army. No. Like, this would never have happened. We No. never would have been able to afford this. And what a grand adventure that is. You know, there's lots of families out there who like to be close to family, and that means a lot to us too. That it's hard during the holidays being away from family. And, like, not seeing our parents, not seeing our niece and nephew. Like, those are things that are still really hard. But we, especially our family, we're such... We enjoy exploring new places and seeing the world that this life is... That we are very grateful, I should say. I think there's only two states that I haven't been to at this point. So I've traveled a lot of the contiguous United States. Both of us are Navy brats. In fact, our grandparents are retired Navy as well. Like, so we've got a lot of military heritage, but we both broke the mold. We didn't go into the Navy. Yeah. But, so to us being in Hawaii, like, this is awesome.
It was my first choice in the Marine Corps.
And then you never got in the Marine Corps, but we got it when we...
Yeah, I didn't even have this on the list.
We were expecting North Carolina, and we got Hawaii. We're like, oh my God, Hawaii. It's so amazing. John's like, nah, they don't get deployed very much. And I'm like, I don't care. We're going to Hawaii. So, for you guys, we hope that you had a wonderful Thanksgiving. And, you know, mahalo for watching. Thank you guys very much. We'll catch you next week.